Hello, good evening. I will try not to make you too tired, and I know there are not too many Hebrew speakers here, so I will read only two short paragraphs from my late novel, Sherit HaChaim in Hebrew, The Remains of Love in English, and Parima de Viața in Romanian. The book starts with an old lady who is lying in bed and cannot move. I remember Amos Oz, the Israeli writer, once told me that it needs a lot of courage to open the book with an old lady who is lying in bed and cannot move. It's not sexy. And how can you attract your readers with this old lady, he asked me. And well, it is still an open question, but I think that this lady who cannot really move, she's so dynamic. I mean, she moves so far in her imagination, because she can be a child with her pioneer parents, she can be a young woman, a young mother, she can be all the women that she ever was. So I think I try to show the power of the imagination in this exposition, and the power of the inner world. האומנם גדל החדר, או שמה זוהי שהתקבצה, והרי זה החדר הקטן ביותר בדירה הזהירה כחף יד, ועכשיו כשהיא שוכבת במיטה מבוקר עד ערב, נדמה שממדיו מתעצמים, מאות צעדים יידרשו לה כדי להגיע אל החלון, עשרות שעות, מי יודע אם יספיקו לשם כך חייה, שארית חייה, יש לומר, הישורת האחרונה של נתח הזמן שהוקצב לה, שנראה נצחי למרבה האבסורד, כי דווקא בהיותו חסר תנועה כל כך, נדמה שיימשך עד אין קץ. ונכון שהיא כבר צנומה ומצומקת, קלה כרוח רפאים, נכון שכל משב אוויר עלול לנתק אותה מן המיטה, נדמה שרק משקלה של השמיכה מונע ממנה לרחף בחלל החדר, נכון שכל נשיפה תקרא את החוט האחרון בסליל המחבר אותה אל החיים, אבל מי הוא שינשוף, מי הוא שיתרח בכלל לנשוף לעברה? כן, שנים על שנים עוד תשכב כאן תחת צמיחתה הכבדה, תראה את ילדיה הולכים ומזקינים, את נכדיה הופכים לאנשים. כן, באדישותם המרה ידונו אותה לחיי נצח, כי נדמה לה לפתע שגם כדי למות נחוץ איזה מאמץ, איזו חיוניות של המת העתידי או של סביבתו, נחוצה תשומת לב אישית, המולד האגנית, כמו הכנות למסיבת יום הולדת. גם כדי למות נחוצה מידה של אהבה, ואילו היא כבר אינה אהובה מספיק, אולי אף אינה אוהבת מספיק, אפילו לשם כך. Thank you for your patience. The way I moved from poetry to prose was almost unconscious, because I remember myself starting to write a poem that I knew only the beginning of it. And after 10 or 20 minutes, I realized that the sentences are very, very long, and that I already wrote almost 10 pages of prose. And this was the moment where I realized that I started to write a novel. But I think maybe it's funny, maybe it's a bit private, but I feel that we are all here very intimate together, so I can tell you what influenced my writing in a funny way. I was already after one book of poetry that I published, and it was very well received, but I had to buy most of the copies myself. And then I was this novel that I just I was just telling you how I started to write it. It was published by, but I received awful reviews, and I felt like I don't know if I will be able to write again. And I was very busy working as an editor in a publishing house, and I felt I didn't have time for my own writing, and I was very frustrated and very sometimes even desperate. And of course they didn't pay me at all, and I knew that I cannot go on like this. And one morning I went to the publisher and I told him that he has to pay me more, that I cannot go on like this. And he said, he looked at me in a very, he was very pale, I remember, and his eyes were cold, and he said that he's very sorry, but I'm fired. He has to fire me, remember, Yali? And it was his idea to ask for more money. So now I felt this is my turn to surprise him. So I told him that I'm pregnant. I just realized I'm pregnant the day before, and that he cannot fire me. And this was the turning point of my life. Because at that time I realized that I will not stay in this publishing house, that he will not keep me there after giving birth, and that this is, and that maybe I don't have to be so devoted to the book I'm editing, and maybe I should steal some time for myself and for my own writing. And I this month of pregnancy and then the first month of the maternity leave were for me the only chance to try again, to try writing again. And this time I was writing without any expectations after the two failures that I experienced. And I wrote it completely free from expectations, and I was just trying to tell the story and to tell it very fast, because I knew that I will have to find another work, and that I will have to that I don't have enough time for my writing. So I was writing the book. I called it Love Life. I was writing the book with the newborn baby in my arms. And when he was almost 1 year old, I think, I finished the book and I started to work in another publishing house as an editor. And when the book was published after half a year, it changed my life.